welcome to this new video. My name is Wendy and today's video is about writing in mails for social selling. And the reason why I'm so specific is because you can use in mails for a lot of other reasons as well. You can use the in mails to find your dream job, to apply for a job, to grow your network, or to get in contact with professionals in your industry. But today I want to talk about in mail for social selling. And it is important to understand that you can only send in mails if you have LinkedIn Premium or LinkedIn Sales Navigator. If you don't have a paid LinkedIn account, you don't have the option to send any in mails. But you can still use this information to send normal messages. The only difference is that you need to be connected to people before you can send a message. Some people have an open profile and you can send them messages without connecting, but most people don't have open profiles. So in mails for social selling. Why are they so important? Well, first of all, imagine the people that you try to reach get a lot of emails every day. I think we all get a lot of emails. And it's really hard to catch up on all those emails. And if the email is not on top of your list, it's easy to forget about the email as well. In-mails are a bit more exclusive, which means that the people that you reach out to don't get that many in-mails per day. How many in-mails do you get yourself? Think about it. Maybe one per week. So the big difference is that it is more exclusive, but it's also a message on a different platform. So it's not their email inbox, it's LinkedIn where they get the message. So before you start to send any in-mails, it's really important that you think about what it is that you try to achieve with your in-mail. And a lot of people use in-mails to get their prospects or customers on the phone. And that's a really good call to action in an in-mail. Because in an in-mail, you don't have the option to share any links. Of course, you can type in a link, but the link won't be clickable. So it's not a hyperlink. So people need to copy and paste the link into their browser before they can actually visit the landing page or the information that's on the link you shared. So it's not really a good option to share any links in your in-mails. But again, a lot of people use in-mails to get people on the phone. And as I said, that's a really good CTA. But you can also use in-mails for other reasons. So if you are a social seller and you want to build up relationships with your prospects, it's important that you do your homework first. So when you have a list of prospects that you want to reach for a specific reason, maybe you want to invite them to an event or you want to talk about a new product that you try to sell, do a bit of research on their profiles. Try to understand who they are, what's important to them, what type of content do they share. And again, for the people who have a Sales Navigator license, it's really easy to use Sales Navigator to get this information. So spend some time on your Sales Navigator and understand the types of content that your prospect shared, the types of actions that your prospect took. Maybe your prospect just got a new job, he got promoted, he was mentioned in the news. Use this type of information when you start to write your in-mail. So when you know what is in the interest of your prospect, think about what it is that you try to achieve with your in-mail. So you want to get them on the phone. Try to write an in-mail that is personal, to the point, not too long, and has a very strong call to action. And with a very strong call to action, I mean, be very specific when you want to speak with this person. So an example could be, if you see that somebody switched jobs, that you send an in-mail that starts with congratulations on your new job. Maybe you can say something about the company they recently joined or the company they left. Tell a bit about why you sent this person an in-mail. So one of the reasons can be, we have this amazing event coming up and I think it's highly relevant for you to attend. And have a strong CTA, as in, can I give you a call at Wednesday, 3 o'clock? The reason why you need to be specific is because this is a trigger for people to come back to you. If you give them a specific time and date, they know that you will give them a call, and make a note, of course, so you can actually make the call at that specific day and time. And if this day or time doesn't fit in their diary or a calendar, they will send you a message back and they will suggest another day or time. If you send a very open message that says, can I give you a call next week? There's not really an urgency for the prospect to send you a message back, because they will think, okay, let's see if they give me a call or not. and I decide next week if I'm in for a call or not. So be very, very specific. Hopefully this helps you to write good in-mails, and don't forget to have a good profile first, of course. If you don't have a complete LinkedIn profile, it's really, really hard to get messages back. So let me know if you have any questions. You can leave them in the comments below, or you can send me a message, of course. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And I see you in my next video.